to reinvest your talent and your mission. I challenge you to reinvest yourself in some new dimension, a renewed, a reset dimension for you in this place. Then rethink is the next one. Engage one's brain. They say that we only use part of our brain, and it depends on which part, if you're left brain or right brain. But we only use part of it. But there's a time in which God intends us to really use our thinking and our brain. In Romans, the 12th chapter, he writes this to the Roman church. He writes, therefore, and again, whenever I see that word therefore, I have to say, what's it therefore? And it's therefore because it's a summation of everything that went before. So it's a summary kind of statement. He says, therefore, I urge you, challenge you, call you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy. That's key. Think about what God's done for us. In view of that, offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is true worship. Do not be conformed to the pattern of this world, but be transformed, metamorphosized. Be transformed by the renewal of your mind. There's the brain part of it. And then he says, then you will be able to test and prove what God's will is for your life. His good, pleasing, and perfect will. To use our minds. Now that's not a substitute for action. But it is a prelude to the right action, to use our minds to figure out God's purpose for me and then move it into action. So, to rethink is critical and crucial. The other, next term is research. To research things. There's a kind of a new vocabulary coming out, one of the words of which is sup. Sup. Hey, bro, what's up? And what that means is, what is the particular existential environment in which you are entering these days? So, well, the research aspect says to you, so, what's going on around you? What are opportunities in your neighborhood, for example? Where is the person, my brother here, who's going to leave us before too long, Anderson, said there's a need for people out there, a one-on-one need. Maybe sub is for you to reach out and find someone through that ministry or on your own, someone who just needs a friend. A friend. You can do that. Amen? Challenge you to figure out sup. Then the next one is relationship. And this is one I have to be careful of because I can go a long time on relationships. You know there's nothing more important than relationships. Choir, do you know that? There's nothing more important than relationships. And there are two dynamics to this relationship angle. And one of those, if you look at the cross, one of those is the vertical one, the one between you, the believer, and our Lord Jesus Christ. And the other dynamic is the relationship between you, the believer, and every other person in your sphere of influence. And these two dynamics are so unique in that they form the cross. And that's what this book is all about. In fact, that's all this book is about, as far as I'm concerned, as far as I can read. It's about relationships. So they're so vital. Make sure your relationship with your Lord and Master is in tune and that you are enjoying it and learning and growing in it. Opportunities here at this church abound to help you do that. That's one relationship. The other relationship is that vertical or horizontal. If there's something between you and some other person, change it. If there's an anger or resentment in the past, remember what Paul said? Forgetting what is behind and straining forward to what is ahead, I press on. It's time. Did you know that to forgive is not an option for us Christians? To forgive or not forgive? If we are a believer in Jesus Christ and His Holy Spirit dwells within us, we are empowered and enabled by His Spirit, there is no option other than to forgive whatever's back there. I took a little inventory after the first two services on the way out, and I asked people, which one of these words kind of struck you? Was there one that kind of stood out? I think there will be one for each of us. And a number of them said this one, because it's so important to you and to God's kingdom. Relationships. And the next one is responsibility. Responsibility. Jesus said, here's this word again, therefore, summation. Imagine the whole gospel of Matthew. Therefore, go. Not just stay where you are, but go. Make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and Son and Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey all that I have commanded you. You, nor I, nor Northlake Church can get anywhere at all without taking responsibility. Responsibility for our choices. Responsibility for our health. Responsibility for our attitude. I have a sermon that it's actually the only one ever people ever asked me to repeat. Just one. The sermon was no excuses. There's no excuses. I can't do that. I can't do that. Yes, you can. You can choose. God gives you that privilege. Responsibility. Take it. It is God's gift to you. You can take new responsibilities. I challenge you. Be a responsible member of this body of Christ for your life. And then finally, to wrap it all up and to renew. That's what it means. When you come back here Sunday after Sunday after Sunday, you have the worship and the beautiful music, and you have the prayers and time, but it's really every Sunday is a renewal time, a refuel time to press on in the week ahead, in the decade before us. So it's a renewal time. When you go out these doors, renew something in your life today. Okay? Do you hear me?
Yeah.
All of them together. Read those with me, if you would, please. Reset. Reimagine. Reinvest. Rethink. Research. Relationships, responsibility, and renew. What do you need to renew? Your choice. God gives you the privilege of choosing and then enabling by His Spirit to make it happen. Count on that Spirit. Lord Jesus, we thank you. We thank you for Paul's word to forget what happened yesterday, to move forward to what you are in the process of coming, making come to be in each one of your brother, each one of my brothers and sisters, each one of your creations here. Thank you. I thank you for the privilege of sharing this good news that Jesus is Lord. Lord of all life, and Lord of each of our lives. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Jesus. So come, O Holy Spirit, fall upon your servants.